Hello, welcome. I'm Aparna Chirumamilla, PhD candidate from Department of Computer Science at Faculty of Information Technology and Electrical Engineering at NTNU. I'm supervised by Professor Guttam Sindri, Professor John Crosty, and Professor Monica Dektini. In this trial lecture, I'll talk about interoperability in e-learning information system. As outline for this topic, I will provide some introduction about e-learning information system and interoperability. And I will talk about general principles of interoperability. And I will explain about different levels of interoperability and provide information, explain about interoperability in e-learning information system, and discuss about several challenges for interoperability in e-learning information system, and give future directions and perspectives. As a definition, e-learning information system can be defined as an intersection of ICT technology that an organization uses for collection, delivery, tracking, and processing of learning related data and business processes between people and technology. It can be either done through internet or intranet. In other way, e-learning information system is basically a collection of components that can be used for that supports interaction between people and technology for learning related activities. And these components can be a learning management system that supports courses, and a learning content management system that can be used for authoring contents. And it can be a e-assessment system that supports exams. And it can be a authentication system that identifies students, or it can be a archival system that publish contents, or it can be a any other system that supports question and answers and webinars, and plugins that support extended third-party functionalities. As a definition for interoperability, interoperability is basically a capability of two or more systems to exchange the data and use the data that has been exchanged. And this can be mainly done, depend upon two aspects, syntactic aspect and semantic aspect. First, syntactic aspect is referred to describing the exact format of the data exchange in terms of the grammar and format. And in semantic aspect refers to providing the meaning of the data to the exchange, to the system, so that they can understand the data in a way that you provide the vocabularies and the schemata to describe the data exchanges. And this interoperability plays an important role in sharing and reusing of the data and content between different components in e-learning information system. People often use interoperability and integration in interchangeable manner, but they are made for different purposes. When components or systems are integrated, then there is a more dependency between components or systems, and they can also share some of their tasks. And but the downside of this integrated system is that if one system is one system have some issues, then it will halt whole the system. And in case of interoperability, the data exchange is mainly happens through interface. So there will be a more, components will be a more function in an independent way. Now we will look through general principles of interoperability. The main reason for using interoperability is to reduce administrative work, and so that it can increase the effectiveness and efficiency for content creation as well. And then when you use the interoperability, then there will be a more openness for the data, and you can also use, you will also use more specifications and open specific, you can use open standards. And when there is a interoperability, then there will be a more availability of interfaces and protection of the personal data, and reusability will be improved because systems share the content between them, and data portability will be there, and as well as interoperability is mainly aimed for increasing user centricity and also to make the data accessible, as well as to make the data secure, and to make a secure transfer of data between systems. There are different levels of interoperability. Now we will go through four levels of interoperability from European interoperability framework. There are two more layers for this from European interoperability framework. Now here we will discuss about the four layers that are majorly used for data exchange between the systems. Technical interoperability is mainly about planning for technical issues involved with the data exchange. Thinking about what kind of interface specifications can be used, and what kind of the integration services will be involved, and as well as what kind of data format has to be used, as well as communication protocols has to be used. And regarding to semantic interoperability, it is at the more semantic level, so that data that is being exchanged between the system can be understandable to systems that are exchanging the data. So this is basically done through developing vocabularies and the schemata of the data being exchanged. And organizational interoperability, this is mainly about aligning or documenting business processes and responsibilities and expectations. So with this, actually organizations work to document, can also get mutual beneficial goal. It is mutually beneficial for them to collaborate in this way. And legal interoperability, as per legal interoperability, this is mainly about checking interoperability issues, whether they have any problem with the legislature or sectoral or geographical restrictions to use the system or to exchange the data. Interoperability in e-learning, now we will go through interoperability in e-learning information system. There are several standards for interoperability in e-learning, and most of them are directly focusing on structure of the data that has to be exchanged between the systems. And they're mainly used for creating and sharing e-learning content material, and for defining a structure of metadata. And except first three standards, other standards, first three standards are mainly referred to providing defining a structure of the data. And when you look through QTI, this is specifically used for creating the questions and assessments, and also sharing this content and results between authoring tools and item banks. As for LDI is concerned, this is about connecting external third party tools with LMS and some other standards. They are mainly focusing on students with special needs and about for interoperability among education institutions. Now we will go through technical interoperability in e-learning information system first. Here mainly, I will explain how technical interoperability can be implemented in intra-organization, how it is used in organization as well as between organizations. When organization want to use new e-learning system, when they want to migrate to the new e-learning system, when there is a technical interoperability, then it will be easier for them to migrate to the new system. And technical interoperability also help organizations to customize the software according to their needs, as well as it will help them to simplify their administrative work. Basically, interoperability is meant for reducing the resources with integrating each and every application. In this figure, you can see there are many tools are being used in this scenario, and you can see there is a student information system that works as a backend for storing the data, student enrollment related data and grades, and learning management system. Here it is being now understand that learning management system is basically used for only courses, and digital content repository, this is being used for storing the content. And here these components are using standardized interfaces, and as well as using standards for exchanging the data and as well as for exchanging the content. And this is about technical interoperability in the organization, the purpose of using technical interoperability in the organization. And between the organizations, it is basically technical interoperability will provide a unified way for communicating between e-learning systems. And as an example, you can see here, there are different e-learning systems that are exchanging the data between them, so that educators from different institutions can create the contents and share the contents. And so in this case, different students also can take courses in different education institutions and get their grades credited to them in their own education institution. As for semantic interoperability in e-learning information system, the best example, I didn't find a really best example, but I think LTI can be useful in a semantic level, because here you can see, first we will go through the technical architecture of LTI application. Here there is a learning management system that is being used by instructor and the students. And we have one more application that is developed by external developers and or content providers. And this could be a LTI tool provider, and this is a LTI tool consumer, LMS. And LTI launch will host external application in the LMS. Now we will go through example for semantic interoperability. This could be an example. Like here you can see that Moodle is getting connected to personalized learning environment. So here basically Moodle is trying to get information about the learner from external third party environment, other environment that is having external third party tools. For instance, here learner has done some learning from WordPress and Flickr and another tool. Then BLTI is basically providing this learning context to Moodle to let educator grade learner based on external environment. Here, basically, there is a service-oriented architecture has been used. And Maybe going through each and every technical detail will be difficult, but basically thing is that grader will use grader can also use external information in the Moodle itself to grade the learner. But in this way, in another way would be to Moodle to send learner information to external third-party solution so that learner can get grades in learner could get grades from Moodle to external third-party solutions as well. And regarding the literature on different levels of interoperability, there is so much contribution related to either providing a concern or providing a solution to interoperability. And when it comes to technical interoperability, there is evidence of not having integration between LMS and e-assessment system. This is also relevant to our own university because we use here Inspira assessment as a e-assessment system and Blackboard as LMS, and we don't have integration between them. So it will create some administrative work to create content several times. And basically teachers in NTNU want to reuse questions from e-assessment system to LMS, but now we don't have an integration, so it is not possible to do it. And move on to the next concern. Researchers say that there will be authentication authorization of the user's problem. There will be a concern with authentication and authorization when interoperability is implemented, because interoperability let multiple system to communicate, and it will also create problems with authentication and authorization of the users. But what if there is a single sign-on implemented? Maybe it would be a good idea if there is a single sign-on implemented, and so that multiple systems can use. And semantic interoperability, as for semantic interoperability, most of the research is concentrated on this level comprehensive semantics and making more formal models, because semantic is all about meaning of the data. So formal models really help with providing concepts, but it is also hassle to make more formal models, because each application will have a different each application will use different language. So it is cumbersome to provide formal models. So, there is a mention of challenges with context awareness. Yeah, all these papers are directly relevant to adaptive learning and providing personalized context to learners. When it comes to organizational and legal interoperability, there were more concerns about digital rights management of educators while sharing the content, and also there were concerns about students' privacy rights when there is an organizational and legal interoperability. As for challenges for interoperability in e-learning information system, first challenge would be about interoperability prioritization. Because universities usually prioritize new functional features than interoperability, and also one more challenge is giving more priority to legal regulations than interoperability, to satisfy legal regulations. We have to somehow cannot send data to another systems. And another issue is with vendors using their own specifications than standards. and it is also same referred to vendor lock-in. This is used by vendors as a low business strategy. And another challenge is about lacking pedagogical knowledge and strategy for e-learning technology. And regarding future directions and perspectives, there will be a number of perspectives. First one is about the LTI tool. This tool is, as we learned in the previous slide, so this tool is really helpful for hosting external third-party applications in the LMS itself. So it will be helpful for educational institutions, because they do not have to use so many systems, and as well as it will also reduce a lot of time involved with integrations. So maybe better to use this functionality. There should be a more training is required for users to get maximum benefits out of it. And another future perspective would be to develop a methodology to support educators in making appropriate decisions so that they can optimally combine educational resources. Because currently technology is lacking of providing the pedagogy and strategy to combine different e-learning resources. And also there would be a need for user involvement in acquisitions, because large acquisitions are usually based upon administrative roles. So they may not consider more into the user's perspective. And another future direction would be to use a systematic interoperability assessment approach. And this is concerned as a shortcoming in previous literature. This concern is described as a shortcoming, but there should be a more need of improvement towards this. And another future perspective would be to moving to open source products than proprietary products. Because as we heard from previous slides, that vendor lock-in is a big problem for getting most benefit of interoperability. And they can also be a less, and another future direction would be to focus more on other interoperability levels, because now we don't have so much literature on organizational and legal interoperability. So so to recap what we have discussed in the previous slides, basically we are talking about interoperability and e-learning information system. And we went through different levels of interoperability: syntactic, technical interoperability, semantic interoperability, organizational and legal interoperability. And then we focused on particularly interoperability referring to e-learning information system. And then we went through what kind of standards are there for e-learning in perspective to interoperability in e-learning, and how they help in basically most of the standards. We heard that most of the standards are providing just structure of way to provide a structure of the content, but there is still lacking in providing formal models for to do more semantic exchanges between the systems. And as well as we heard about different challenges involved with interoperability in e-learning information system. First challenge discussed was about giving prioritization, and second challenge was about technology lacking pedagogical strategies. And we also learned about vendor lock-in, how it happens in the case of how it makes interoperability it makes issue for interoperability. And And in future directions, we discussed that there should be a more improvement towards prioritizing, including users in acquisition, so that there will be a more prioritization to interoperability. So thank you for listening to my presentation.